Maturing the saints, discipling the nation.
Bible says, therefore, leaving the discussion of the elementary principles of Christ, let us go on to perfection. The word perfection there is a key word that means teleos. I read on. Not laying again the foundation of repentance from dead works, and of faith towards God, and of the doctrine of baptisms, and of laying on of hands, and of resurrection of the dead, and of eternal judgment. Now here the scripture makes it so clear to us that our ultimate destination as God's children is perfection. Teleos, that's what the word perfect, that's what the word teleos means from the root, the Greek meaning. It means perfection. It means completion or maturity. So as a child of God, the point that the Lord ultimately intends that you will attain before you can fulfill the purposes of God, before you can lay hold on all the resources of the kingdom and be everything God has called you to be, is perfection, maturity. God intends that we mature. You know, previously we've seen that the call of God and the mandate of God for your life as a child of God is for you to attain maturity, perfection in Christ Jesus. Now, when you're living with this sense, with this mindset and this mentality, you realize that it becomes natural for you to begin to grow in faith. The Holy Spirit of God will begin to work in you to will and to do of God's good pleasure. You begin to mature and develop in understanding. You begin to mature and develop in character. The Bible tells us from this scripture, we can see clearly that there are two stages, spiritual stages, two levels of grace, two realms of grace. There are two stages of spiritual growth. The first stage is that of a babe, the babyhood, and the second stage, which is the adulthood. And the Bible tells us that a babe requires the milk of the word. It ought to depend on the milk of the word so that it can develop and mature. Now, oftentimes we get into a situation, we find a situation where we begin to introduce the solid food, the meat of the word, to babes. And what comes out of that is dysfunctionality. We begin to see a situation where certain people feel that they don't even need pastors. They are so mature. They overestimate themselves, because they are, this time around, they are not, that they are suffering from stunted growth. God expects us as young new believers or children in the faith to grow effectively in faith. You ought to be established in the basic and fundamental of faith, of baptism of the Spirit, of repentance from dead work, teachings that the word of faith teaching is like righteousness, justification. And as we to get exposed to the Spirit, we begin to realize the rights and privileges in Christ Jesus. And as we begin to get exposed to the Spirit, to mature, and we can undo the different dimensions of understandings of God and different aspects of the kingdom. So, but the will of God is not that we should remain as babes. God expects that we should grow into adulthood, where we become skillful in the things of the Spirit. You know, these are the attributes of maturity. A mature man in the faith and in grace will develop in character. He will be somebody that manifests Christ in his attribute. He will manifest the fruit of the Spirit, the love of God, the patience of God, the kindness of God, the temperance and self-control. He's able to put his body under. All these are characteristics of meekness, characteristics of spiritual growth and a mature believer in Christ Jesus. Number two, a mature man in the faith is someone that operates in discernment. He is not moved and motivated by circumstances, the natural circumstances of life. It's rather moved and motivated by the Spirit of God. He operates in discernment. He's able to identify what is of God and what is not of God. He can't be deceived. And that's the will of God for your life. And third, we can see that a man that is mature in faith is a man of spiritual authority. It's a man that can handle spiritual authority by the virtue of wisdom. He's deep in the things of God. The Bible says, we speak wisdom among the mature. The problem many people are suffering from is that of a problem of spiritual stagnation. Many people are on the same spot. They are not growing spiritually. It's not because they are babes, they are new believers. They've been believers all these years, but not growing spiritually. They can't take responsibility. But God is calling you to action. He's calling you to maturity. Sad maturity is spirituality. Spirituality is determined by character. It's determined by your ability to respond to the leadings of the Holy Spirit. And I release grace of God upon your life to bring you out of that state of stagnation and cause you to begin to enter into the purposes and the will of God for your life. The Lord is calling you forth. There's a release of virtue. There's a release of divine enablement and the impartation of grace to cause you to begin to mature in faith so that you will no longer be deceived by the spirit of deception and the spirit of lawlessness and falsehood that is out there. But you begin to rise up as giant in the faith that you are, affecting the circumstances and situations of life, living above sins and temptations of the enemy. And the glory of God is going to rest upon your life, upon your destiny, upon your family, and you will become a light in your generation that you are called to be. And as you begin to function with this mindset and understanding, then you will be giant in the land, in the realm of the spirit, affecting policies in this nation, affecting the outcome of events around you. You begin to function as kings that you are in Christ Jesus. There's a call of the Spirit. There's a cry of the Spirit calling us as God's children unto spiritual maturity. And as you begin to yield to this, the blessing and impartation of the grace of God will rest upon your life. And then you will be light of God in your generation and be a true representative of God's kingdom in the head. May the Lord God be with you in Jesus' name. Mature.